Good morning and welcome to Hope for the Family with Evangelist Moyo Antonia Edem. God is good all the time. We bless God for keeping us alive to see this vision day which He has made. We rejoice and gladden it. Shouts of victory and rejoicing ahead all the time in the tent of the righteous. We bless God for sending forth prosperity to us this day, for sending forth good health to us this day. We bless God for His peace that surpasses human understanding, that dwells amongst us in the name of Jesus Christ. We are the children of God, channels of His peace. Today we are woken up to a bright and beautiful day. We are rejoicing this day because God has given us everything we need today. We do not lack anything good. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We thank God that today we are going to meditate on the word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The word He spoke to you, the rich man and his disciples. Amen. We want to take up on that passage that with God, nothing is impossible. Jesus Christ told the rich man to go sell everything he has, that he go give everything he has to the poor. Amen. The rich man could not comprehend why Jesus Christ said. The word said that his face fell when Jesus Christ said so, because he was a worthy man. Amen. That he would go sell everything he had accumulated over the years and give them to the poor. That was too much for him to take. Today God may be telling us to do something that we think that is impossible, but we want to feed on the word of God that with God nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. We want to feed on the word of God that everyone that leaves family, that says that they worth everything that God has given to them to follow Him, will not lack anything, that they will have more than 1,100-fold of whatever they are leaving behind to follow God. God is going to provide everything we need. He is God. He has spoken His word and He will not disappoint us. That you have everything. Everything, and along with that, you also have persecution in this world. People will come against you because the word came against our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The spirit of this world is contradicting the spirit of God, trying to come against what God is doing in our lives. The spirit in this world is lying, trying to hold men back so that they will not receive the salvation of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The spirit of this world is trying to offer men things, position, influence, trying to give them material wealth. But for their souls, amen, deceiving them, and men have gone to the wrong places to receive influence, power, amen, to receive material wealth from the spirit of this world, and they are walking about blinded. But when we come to God, our eyes are enlightened. We are filled with the wisdom of God. We will receive the help we need, amen, to continue to do good works for God. We receive everything that comes with obeying God. Amen. All the good things that God has promised us, and we are able to continue to live in this world. And in this world, we prosper and we receive the eternal salvation. Amen. In God's eternal kingdom, as God has promised us in the name of Jesus Christ. So let us come to God today. Let us be attentive to the word of God. Let the Spirit of God speak to our spirit, mind, and soul today. Let God lead us. Let us learn from the experience of this young rich man that came to God. And feed on the word of Jesus Christ today. It's for us. It's for us. When we give to God, to bless His kingdom, God gives back to us more than we can ever imagine. Amen. With God, nothing is impossible. We have come to the God that can do the impossible in our lives today. God that can use us to do great works today. Whatever we are passing through today, we will put them at the altar and believe that God will help us today. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Before we go into the reading of the word this morning, let us just pray that God, we give us everything we need. We begin to reveal to us what we need to take out from this passage today. That God will feed us with the living word of God today. That this word will produce the fruit of righteousness in each of one of us. That we receive from this word today, that we write it, distribute it to the people around us today in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray today for the spirit of revelation. We pray for understanding. We pray for strength. Spiritual strength to do great works for God today in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray today that we'll see ourselves in the light of God's word today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, as we have come to you today, we plead the blood of Jesus. We ask for forgiveness in ways we have fallen short of your glory, in ways we have turned back against you, in ways we have not done the things you have called us to do in this world. Let your spirit begin to reveal to us the things we need to change about ourselves today in the name of Jesus Christ. May we see ourselves in the light of your word today. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ, we ask for forgiveness for ourselves, for our families, for our nations, and the body of Christ. have mercy upon us where we have fallen short of your glory, where we have become too greedy, where we have thought about ourselves alone, and we have forgotten, O Lord God, to think about your children in our midst, your children in our nations. God, forgive us this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your love dwell richly in our hearts today. Your love for our brothers and sisters, as you have loved us, may we love the people around us today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, we come against every spirit of fear in us today, every unbelief, and we feed on your word this morning. Father, help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Anything that will take from us, that will take the meaning of this passage from us today, remove it from us in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us truly feed on your word. Let it feed our spirit, mind, and soul today in the name of Jesus Christ. Let our bodies be strengthened by your word today in the name of Jesus Christ. Let healing flow from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet today. Let your word be back with your miracles, signs, and wonders in our lives and our communities today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let your word, Father, Lord, illuminate, Father, Lord, our path today in the name of Jesus Christ. That this word will be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path today in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us be fruitful in all we do for you today in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we bless you this morning. We have not come before a God that we do not trust. We have come to you, God, who helps us in all our situations. God who created us, the only one and true God, our most wise God, God who loves us so much, God who has done great and mighty things in our lives. We praise you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. We ascribe to you the honor that is due to your holy name. We acknowledge that you are our God today, that you are holy. There is no God except. We thank you, Jehovah God, that you are God who presides in the great assemblies, assembly of the gods. That the gods come before you, Father Lord. They fear you in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you that kings from distant land, O Lord God, we come to you to worship you, to honor you today in the name of Jesus Christ. That God, we bless you that the words you have sent forth, Father Lord, will go out of the uttermost ends of the world. They will not return to you empty in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, that we have come to a beautiful place today to meet with you, to the new Jerusalem, to the city of our God in the name of Jesus Christ. That we have come to you, the judge of the old world, in the name of Jesus Christ. That we have come to a place where we can touch you today, where we can receive from you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Jehovah God, that we have come to a place where we have made right the souls of righteous men perfect today in the name of Jesus Christ. We have come, Father Lord, in joyous celebration with the angels, multitude of angels today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are celebrating, Father Lord, our salvation today. We are upholding your testimony that you truly are God, that you are able to do the impossible in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we have come before Jesus Christ today, the mediator of a new covenant. We have come, Father Lord, to him today in the name of Jesus Christ. He's interceding on our behalf. We thank you for all he's doing for us today in the name of Jesus Christ. We have come, Father Lord, to the sprinkled blood of Jesus Christ, speaking better things than the blood of Abel on our behalf, on behalf of members of our families today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we have come to you, Father Lord, for we belong to the church of the firstborn, Father Lord, your first children, Jehovah God, that have been redeemed, whose names are written in heaven in the name of Jesus Christ. We have every reason to rejoice today. We do not take lightly our grace, Jehovah God, the grace you have given to us in the name of Jesus Christ. We will not miss your grace in Jesus' mighty name. We will not become sexually immoral like Esau in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, we repent of anything in us, Father Lord, that will make us to turn our backs against you, Jehovah God. We know you are a consuming fire, Jehovah God, that you love us so much, that you are speaking from heaven. Who can turn their back against you when you speak to us from heaven? When those who were here before, on earth, Father Lord, could not turn, could not refuse, could not turn away from you when you spoke, O Lord God, from the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. You have promised that you will shake both the heavens and the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. You are God. We bless you, Father Lord, as we feed on your word today. Let your fear be in our hearts, O Lord God. Let us be obedient to your will in the name of Jesus Christ. Have your way in our lives. Do what you alone can do in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you this morning. We thank you. We commit our families unto your hands today. Thank you for blessing us with fruitfulness. Thank you for blessing us with the ability to reproduce, to multiply, to replenish the health, Lord God. Thank you that we conquer the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jehovah God, that you are able to carry your mandate upon us and our families in the earth you have given to us in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you that our husbands are priests in our homes, Lord God. Thank you that we wives are united with our husbands in holy matrimony and in ministry work. Thank you, Jehovah God, that we are fruitful vines in our homes in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you that our children are olive shoots on their father's tables. Thank you that no weapon fashioned against us and our families will prosper. Thank you, Jehovah God, that our children are sent into a position of leadership, Lord God, in our families and nations, Lord God. Thank you for the good gifts you are giving to us and our children. We dedicate them to you this day. No weapon fashioned against us and our families will prosper. Thank you, Jehovah God, for cleansing out evil from our schools, Lord God, from our communities, Jehovah God, for holding back the hands of those trying to go into our schools with drugs, with alcohol. using children in sex trade, in child labor. Thank you for bringing them down in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for lifting up a standard against those recruiting our children in gangs and terrorist sets, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless you, God, for all you are doing for us. Thank you that the enemy cannot find an entrance into our homes, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ. For our children are giving us strength in Jesus' mighty name. This morning, Jehovah God, we commit unto your hands, your children looking up to you for the blessing of the womb. Touch them this day. Bless their wombs, oh Lord God, to carry pregnancy to full term. Rebuke abortion and miscarriage on behalf of your children today in the name of Jesus Christ. Our Father, our Lord, we bless you this morning. Touch your sons that they will be able to impregnate their wives in Jesus' mighty name. Jehovah, arise unto us and help us, Jehovah God. You are our portion in the land of the living. You have helped us, Jehovah God. You will not turn your back against us. You are our God. You created us for good purpose, Jehovah God. May we give you pleasure through the things you do today in the name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah God, help your daughters bringing babies into this world, Father Lord. Let your spirit over around the maternities and help them to push their children forth, to bring their children forth into this world in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless you on parents and life, babies and life in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless your babies that have been dedicated to you, O Lord, our God, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for revealing death at childbirth, for overturning the curse, O Lord God, for discussing those that came against our mothers in the name of Jesus Christ. Those that said evil words against us, that swore, Father Lord, have sent that by baby Hebeshinda. We overturn their curses in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for being our God, for breaking snares and making our souls to fly out of the fallen snare. Thank you, Jehovah God, that we are flying free today as of eagle wings, O Lord God, leaping over walls. Walls are coming down because of us today in the name of Jesus Christ. We are able to do the impossible because you are our God in the name of Jesus Christ. It's you, nothing is impossible. Thank you for that name of Jesus Christ you have given to us. We lift up the banner of Jesus Christ where we are today in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you that we prevail against the forces of darkness. Wherever they are gathered, they are falling into the pit they have dug with their own hands and overtaken by their own evil devices in Jesus' mighty name. Oh God Almighty, we bless you for your compassion around us and our communities, Lord God, as the mountain of compassion around Jerusalem. Thank you for protecting us from the devices of the wicked, Jehovah God. Thank you for being our God involved in the affairs of men in Jesus' mighty name. This morning we commit unto your hands our leaders and our nations, Lord God. We pray that you touch them, Jehovah God, that wisdom speaks to them in the name of Jesus Christ. We praise you for their good works in our nations, Lord God. We thank you that the gods of this world will not blind our leaders in the name of Jesus Christ. They will not go to the wrong place to acts of power or influence in the name of Jesus Christ. They will come to you. They will surrender to your will in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for using them to do good works in our nations, for providing the needs of your children in our communities. We lift up before you today all the heads of departments, everyone in position of leadership over us in our nations, Lord God. Father, anyone that has dedicated their nations, Lord God, to the word of your court, hold them down today in the name of Jesus Christ. Release the nations to your children, Jehovah God. Every strange altars, every word spoken over our nations, according to your will, are coming down by the power of the living God. Every covenant taken on behalf of your people in the nations, Lord God, be overturned by the power of the living God. Father, prevail in the matters concerning your children. Let men know that you are men, that you are God involved in the affairs of your children. Jehovah God, deliver us and our people from the hands of the strong men and women in our nations in the name of Jesus Christ. Those that are after their bellies, Lord God, that do not have the true love of God for humanity, let them not stand in position of leadership over us. Let their position become vacated by your mighty power in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your children in government, Lord God, do the impossible in our nations, Lord God. You are God who empowers your children to do the impossible, Jehovah God. For with you, nothing shall be impossible. Let your children speak as your oracles in the name of Jesus Christ. Let them lift up the banner of Jesus Christ. Let them, Father Lord, begin to take care of your children in their community, the poor and needy, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the words you spoke to the rich man, Lord God, be the portion of our leaders in the name of Jesus Christ. As they take care of your children in our communities in Jesus' mighty name. May they not embezzle the money, Father Lord. Take what you have given to the nations to themselves, Jehovah God. May they provide the basic welfare services that your children need in the nations in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father Lord, may they administer justice in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May they uphold the truth in Jesus' mighty name. Jehovah God, we thank you for what you do through your children in government. We pray, Jehovah God, that they will not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is your power that brings salvation to men. We pray, Jehovah God, that they will uphold the banner of Jesus Christ and begin to do great works to you. Let your word be a lamp unto their feet and a light unto their path in the name of Jesus Christ. Let them turn back to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, let them overturn things done in our nations that have violated the spiritual principles you have laid down for the nations in the name of Jesus Christ. By keeping them, Father Lord, we are warned by them. We are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah God, we lift up the marriage institution to you. That marriage is a union between a man and a woman. It's the first institution you you created, Jehovah God. Oh, it's through this instruction that we reproduce, that we carry out your mandate upon our lives in this world. We come against you, you evil force of darkness, trying to come against marriage institutions. We come against you. We overturn every work you have done in our nations contrary to the will of God. We come against you in the name of Jesus Christ, that we marry men to female, our children will marry men to female. We come against you. We silence your voice of opposition in our government in the name of Jesus Christ. We come against policies that have been issued and contrary to the will of God. Father, arise unto us and forgive us in Jesus' mighty name. Have mercy upon the nations in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your children live for you. Let your light shine in our government in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, where each that deliberated in the nations, let your spirit be there to help our people in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let jobs be created in our nations, Lord God. Let the youth, Lord God, be engaged positively in our communities in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the young adults, Lord God, let them, Father, Lord, receive every service they need in our nations in the name of Jesus Christ. Let families be strengthened. Let our own citizens receive the help they need in our nations, Father. We bless you for all you are doing for us this morning. You are God, be thou exalted. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you for the body of Christ, and the body of Christ will continue to do great works in our nations. That the body of Christ, Lord God, we continue to be a united body in Christ, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, God Almighty, that false prophets and teachers will not reign in our midst, Lord God. We come against them, we put down their devices in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you that your house, Lord God, will continually be a house of prayer for all nations in Jesus' mighty name. A house of deliverance, a house of peace in Jesus' mighty name. A house where the true love of God Almighty dwells in Jesus' mighty name. Where we are considerate for one another in Jesus' mighty name. That your children can come to the house of God without being afraid, without being intimidated spiritually. We uproot every evil seed sown in our midst, Lord God. Arise unto us this morning, our Father, and help us in Jesus' mighty name. For that our God, there's no God as thee. We bless you for all you have done for us in Jesus' mighty name. Be thou exalted in our midst, O Lord God Almighty. A compass around the church and uproot everything that is sown there that is not of God today. Every bitter seed, O Lord God, everything that will cause confusion, let that be overturned by the power of the living God. Strange altars erected within the house of God will pull down by the power of the living God. Father, we bless you this morning. At this time, we commit unto you, Father Lord, the mission field and those that have gone out into the mission field, Father Lord. Be with them, Father Lord. Let your word be a lamp unto their feet and a light unto their paths, Lord God. Lead them to the uttermost ends of the world, where this word will be preached, where souls will be brought into your kingdom. Those that have been persecuted will inherit your kingdom. Use them to do the impossible in our nations today. Let signs, wonders, and miraculous deeds flow through them today in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your children be delivered from every plan of the wicked in their nations in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the forces of darkness trying to come against the kingdom of God be brought down today in Jesus' mighty name. Let your children trample up anything that stands in our way today. Let the church continue to prevail. Your house will continually be a house of prayer for all nations in the name of Jesus Christ. It will not be a den of robber. We overturn the tables of money changers today in Jesus' mighty name. Every buying and selling within the house of God contrary to the will of God have been overturned by your mighty power today in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, that the church is fruitful. Thank you for the outreach ministry within the church in our communities. Thank you for the good works, Lord God, that spiritual fathers and mothers are doing. Thank you that they rightly distribute the word of truth to their congregation. Continue to encourage and help them, Jehovah God. We bless you this morning for all you are doing in our midst, Lord God, that we are standing in our rightful position within the house of God, doing great works for you. Glory be to your name, O Lord God, for encompassing around us and our families with your holy presence. Thank you for being our God and helper in Jesus' mighty name. Who can stand against us when you are for us? Oh, Father, we thank you for your abiding presence in all our situations. There's no God as they. We bless you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. We commit unto your hands again those that are sick, O Lord God, wherever they are, to touch them, Jehovah God. Touch every organ in their bodies in the name of Jesus Christ. Send forth your word to heal them. Father Lord, change the foundation of evil, Father Lord, in the pharmaceutical companies, Lord God. In the medical profession, Jehovah God. In the laboratories, in the research institutes, Father Lord. In our colleges and universities. Wherever people are gathered for evil purposes, Lord God Almighty. Overturn their evil in Jesus' mighty name. Prevail in the midst of your children. Bless the water we drink in the name of Jesus Christ. We present to you our food processing plants around the world. Bless the food in Jesus' mighty name. Oh God Almighty, bless our reservoirs, lakes, and springs, oh Lord God, water around the world in the name of Jesus, in the bodies of water around the world in the name of Jesus Christ. And Father, flush out every evil from our water in Jesus' mighty name. Bless the soil on which we plant our food in Jesus' mighty name. For you are our God and ever. There is no God as you. We bless you this morning for all you have done for us in the name of Jesus Christ. Be thou exalted in our midst, Lord God. Thank you, Jehovah God, for helping us, for sending forth to us miracle of healing today, for touching our blood pressure, our blood sugar level, for flushing out excessive fat from our bodies today in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jehovah God, for rebuking death by cancer, by heart attack and stroke in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jehovah God, for being our God. We dip in the blood of Jesus Christ everything used in our medical care in the name of Jesus Christ. We come against false diagnosis in Jesus' mighty name. Go rehab sender. Father, Lord, have your way in our lives today in the name of Jesus Christ. Today is election day in the United States of America. We pray, Jehovah God, as we go out to vote, that your wisdom will lead us in Jesus' mighty name to vote for the right candidate in Jesus' mighty name. Let your will be done in the name of Jesus Christ. Help us, Spirit of the Living God, reveal to us the things we need to know about the candidates in the name of Jesus Christ. Let them continue, Father Lord, to utter words that we will hear so that we know them in the name of Jesus Christ. Let nothing be hidden in Jesus' mighty name. Jehovah God, unveil them before us, Father Lord. Let us see them the way they are in the name of Jesus Christ. And help us, Lord God, in all that we do. Let peace reign in our nations in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your children, Father Lord, not come fearful of anyone in Jesus' mighty name. Oh God, we bless you. We thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for leading our police force out in the name of Jesus Christ, in your name, in your power, in your might. Thank you for the military in the name of Jesus Christ. Our soldiers are going out in your name, in your power, in your might, in your authority, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for our secret services and all you are doing through everyone you have placed, Father Lord, in strategic positions in our nations to help us. Jehovah God, as they work for you, continue to bless them and their families in Jesus' mighty name. Be thou exalted in our midst, they are living God. We thank you, God, for all you have done for us this morning, for touching us, for helping us, for sending favor, for sending benefits today, for sending destiny efforts to us today in the name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah God, go ahead of us to our places of work today and uproot everything the enemy has brought in there to cause confusion today. We work for you. Give us strength today. Help us today. Overturn every gathering brought right to us, Father, contrary to your will against us today in the name of Jesus Christ. Those that are gathered against us, let them fall in the pit they have dug with their own hands in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you this morning in Jesus' mighty and precious name. We have prayed. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May our God be exalted in our midst today in Jesus' mighty name. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. This morning I'm going to read from the book of Mark chapter 10, beginning from verse 17. The rich young man. As Jesus started on his way, a man ran up to him and fell on his knees before him. Good teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Why do you call me good? Jesus answered, no one is good except God alone. Even Jesus Christ humbled himself before God. This rich young man was thinking about eternal life. He had material possession, everything here in this world, but he was thinking about the salvation of his souls, of his soul. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. This morning, in whatever position you find yourself in today, are you thinking about the salvation of your soul? Are you seeking Jesus Christ? Are you running after him to ask him that, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Are you ready to receive the answer that he will give to you this day? Are you thinking about what will happen after you die and leave this world? Are you just feeling and enjoying for this moment? There's life after this world. There is going to be judgment. Are you thinking about that? This man was not satisfied with everything he had. He was thinking about the salvation of his own soul. Are we thinking about the salvation of our souls today? Glory, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, amen. So what must I do to inherit eternal life? Why do you call me good? Jesus Christ said, why do you call me good? Jesus answered, no one is good except God alone. God alone is good. When Jesus Christ came to this world as God the Son, he came in human flesh and blood. So he was passing through the same emotions that we passed through. And he acknowledged that no one is good. God alone is good. Amen. What we have today is what God has given to us, the grace of God. None of us is good. God alone is good. We thank God that we have accepted the grace of God, that we have not missed it, we have not turned our back against it. We pray that our brothers and sisters, as are there in the world, we accept the grace of God. Glory, hallelujah, amen. And that's why this word must be preached, that people will know that there's nothing like self-righteousness, that our good works alone will not save us. We must accept what God has given to us, the salvation of Jesus Christ. Glory, hallelujah, amen. That why do you call me good? Jesus alone, Jesus answered, no one is good except God. You know the commandment, do not murder, do not commit adultery, do not steal, do not give false testimony, do not defraud, honor your father and mother. Teacher, he declared, all this I have kept since I was a boy. He has done everything as he has been taught. Some of us finance will say that about ourselves today, that I've kept all the commandments, I've not done anything wrong. But know that just one is good. God alone is good. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Jesus looked at him and loved him. He still loves us today. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Jesus looked at him and loved him. One thing you lack, he said, go sell everything you have and give to the poor. Go sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. Go sell everything you have, give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. You've done good works, you have kept the commandment, but you lack one thing. Go sell everything you have, give to the poor, and come follow me. Jesus Christ will make us fishers of men. He wants to use us to bring souls into the kingdom. He wants to use us to work for God, to give pleasure to God through the things we do today. We are lacking something today. May the Spirit of God reveal to us that thing that we are lacking, so that we not become self-righteous. We not become too critical of everyone. Let us know that no one is good. Only God is good. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us humble ourselves before God today. Go sell everything you have. This is to the rich man. Go sell everything you have and come follow me. Give it to the poor and come follow me. Amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. There is something that we still need, which God alone can give to us through his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us pay attention this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. That go sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. Our treasure should be in heaven, not on earth here. In the name of Jesus Christ. On earth here, it will be destroyed by the insects, by the weather, in the name of Jesus Christ. But in heaven, it will be preserved. Nothing can touch it. Glory, hallelujah, amen. At this man's face fell. He went away sad because he had great wealth. Amen. He was sad because he had great wealth. We feel the same way, that everything I've worked for, everything I've acquired over the years, I'll just give it out like that. It will be hard for us to take. But we want to know that with God, nothing is impossible. Amen. When we surrender ourselves to God, those things will become nothing. They will become commonplace. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. At this, the man's face fell. He went away sad because he had great wealth. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, how hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. The disciples were amazed at his words. Jesus Christ said how hard it is for the rich to enter into the kingdom of God. And his disciples were amazed at his words. Amen. Let's hear what the disciples said. The disciples were amazed at his words. But Jesus said again, children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. How hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. The disciples were even more amazed and said to each other, who then can be saved? We may be feeling the same way, that who can be saved when it's rich, when it's difficult, hard for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. Amen. It is hard to give up what you already have, what you can see, what you have accumulated over the years, what you have believed in. But Jesus Christ has come with a new gift. Amen. To us. The gift of salvation. He has come, he has opened up to us that door through which we must enter. The righteous must come in to receive salvation of God. And he's telling us today that with God nothing is impossible. That thing you are holding on to, that wealth that you love, that influence, that position of pride that you have found yourself in, that you enjoy the attention of people. Because they know you as a leader in your community, that you have so many things. God is saying, give it away. Give it away, that we should first seek his kingdom and his righteousness, and every other thing will be added unto us. That we receive every other thing that we need, it will be added unto us. That's what you think you have. God is going to give you more than that. But first of all, give what you have. Go sell it. Give it to the poor and come follow me. He's going to show us the way. He's going to lay down spiritual principles that we will live by, that will make us to become the people that God wants us to be. That we begin to do the impossible in this world. We must trust God. We must believe in the word of God and follow Jesus Christ to make us fishers of men. That we live by those principles that he has laid for us so that we become the people that God wants us to be in this world, people that can do the impossible, people that can find that door that God has opened unto us, that door of righteousness, and we can come in and begin to show the world that yes, God has given us salvation through his Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, amen. The disciples were even more amazed and said to each other, who then can be saved? Jesus looked at them and said, with men this is impossible. Amen? With men this is impossible, but not with God. All things are possible with God. With men it is impossible to be saved. It is impossible to give up what you have received to follow our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But with God, nothing shall be impossible. Amen. Nothing shall be impossible. When we trust God, when we come to him, nothing shall be impossible. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Peter said to him, we have left everything to follow you. Amen. I tell you the truth. Jesus replied, no one who has left home or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or feet for me and the gospel, we fail to receive 100 times as much in this present age. Homes, brothers, sisters, mothers, children, feet, and with them, persecutions. And in the age to come, eternal life. And in the age to come, eternal life. That no one who has left this thing, things for him, will not inherit his kingdom here in this world, and to come, age to come, you inherit internal life. That's the word of God to us this day. I will take a moment to put on my battery. I will just turn away a little because my battery is not charging this morning. Glory be to God. Glory. Glory be to God. Just a moment, I'll be back. Glory. There's a problem. I don't know. It's not charging, but I'll just continue by God's grace. So whatever we leave today, God is going to give it back to us in abundance. Let us trust God that he's going to give us whatever we have left behind to follow him in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. He is God. He has spoken, and he will do that which he alone can do in our lives. Amen. That and in the age to come, eternal life. But many who are first to be last, and the last to be first. So at this time, we are going to pray. We are going to thank God for eternal life he has given us in Jesus Christ. That we believe that through him, we can do the impossible. Let God touch us this morning and begin to help us and overturn every plan of the wicked. That our hearts and minds and soul will be surrendered to him. That God will begin to use us mightily to do the impossible. That we give whatever he wants us to give us, give away. So that we can follow him to do his will in this world. Father, have your way in our lives. You are our God. We bless you today. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May God be exalted in our lives today. In Jesus' mighty name, you are blessed. God loves you. We love you. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Mm-hmm.